All right, without getting too much into technical or implementation-specific details, a single CPU core can only perform one task at a time. To make it feel like it's performing multiple tasks at the same time, or multitasking, it switches rapidly between many tasks many times per second, and to us, that feels like it's multitasking. It used to be that to switch from one task to another, each task had to voluntarily give up its time with the CPU. So when one task was finished computing for a few milliseconds, it would then tell the operating system, "Hey, operating system, I'm done for now. Give control to someone else." And the operating system would oblige and it would run the next task. And then that one would have to give up control, and then the next task would run. And then the next one, and then the next one, and then eventually it'd go back to the first. And the order in which that runs is an entirely different subject. This was called cooperative multitasking. Each task had to voluntarily give up control of the CPU, and together they all cooperated to make it feel like the whole computer was multitasking and doing all of those things at the same time. The problem with cooperative multitasking arose when you had one task that, for whatever reason, stopped responding. The problem is that every task has to give up the CPU voluntarily. So if you have a task that stops responding, it's not going to give control of the CPU to any other task. And in order to continue to use your computer, you'd have to restart it. And that's where preemptive multitasking comes in. The preemptive part means that the operating system can wrench control back from tasks anytime it wants, really. Well, not exactly, but basically anytime it wants. So if a task is taking too long with the CPU, the operating system just says, "Hey, you're taking too long with the CPU. Give that CPU to someone else. Let them have a turn." And if you had one unresponsive task, that wouldn't bring the whole computer down. And in fact, nowadays, if you have an unresponsive task, you can just go in and terminate it. What you don't have to do is restart your entire machine just because one app stops responding. And this is great. Preemptive multitasking is still used in pretty much all regular workstation computers all the time. The device that you're watching this video on probably uses preemptive multitasking. Are there other types of multitasking? Yeah, there's cooperative and then there's real time, but we don't need to get into that right now. But it's this preemptive multitasking that allows your operating system to run many things at the same time and make them feel like they're all cooperating when they don't really have to. And that's what's great. Now you can use your computer and you have control over individual tasks without the individual tasks hogging control of the computer.